guys, before the video starts, I want to tell you yet again about my Tee Public account. You can visit it over there. You know, I have a bunch of artwork designs for t-shirts, though, and all types of unique and interesting designs, though, that relate to the topics and stuff that I talk about, or other things that I'm just into, though. So if you're nerdy, and if you want some unique, cool designs for a t-shirt, or anything else, though, you could just head over to my Tee Public. Though, you can find my my account on Tee Public, which is PrinceFins54's artwork shop, or you can visit the link on my Facebook account to head right to my Tee Public account, so you could scroll down and see all types of designs. You can get them on not just t-shirts, but stickers and phone books and all types of stuff, though, all like home apparel and all types of things. So again, visit Tee Public, which is PrinceFins54's artwork shop, though, where you can find all my stuff. And actually buying my stuff there helps support my channel and creates more content, though, for you guys. So thank you very much, and on to the rest of the video.
Alright then, so hello, and this is me again, Vincent. Welcome to another episode of my podcast, PrinceFins54's Beyond the Monstars. Though you can find me here on Anchor, of course, though. So it's been a while since I've done something normal, though, because over here on Anchor, the big monkey, King Kong, has been taking up a lot of my time. We just finished King Kong-a-thon a few days ago by the time of this is recording, though, over here on Anchor, though. But for everyone listening, though, this is something not new, but it's going back to basics, back to form, what we usually do. So I'm here with this episode, at least as fast as I can. Ignore all the noises in the background that you hear. I just have atmospheric noise for myself so I can at least concentrate on talking to you guys. So with this episode or whatever we're going to do here, I'm going to talk about all... I haven't done a news thing in like the longest time because a lot of news stuff like I didn't think was worth like talking about, though, except on Instagram maybe. But I decided since there's so much of it, I would think I want to throw like a video or like something out there, though, or this podcast here to talk about all the stuff we've been getting so far, though. So I haven't done a news thing since like what? Probably 2018, I think. I'm pretty sure, though, at least like recorded something, though, about news, though. So I have a bunch of pages. So if anything is not in this, though, or if I missed something, it's probably like something new that probably came out, though, or I just forgot about it, though. So I'm going to the news that as far as I think is worth mentioning, though, in this, from the oldest news that I have to current right now, which is where I'm recording, though. So I have a lot of stuff opened up, though, at least I think I do. I do not have everything opened up, apparently, though. So let me get these pages here though, real quick. I just had a bunch of stuff opened up, though. Now, for some reason, I don't have them open. I thought I did. Weird is that? No, so let me see if I could get this stuff back. Alright. Yeah, alright, I got it. I did it, see? I'm prepared. Or I think I am? Yeah, I'm prepared. Alright. So the first thing in news, I'll just jump right in though. So in the first thing of news, since the new Godzilla Kong trailers came out last month though, and we're really close to the movie's release in March 31st, though, which is insane to think we're almost that, just a little bit longer to wait. We're almost there. But the first thing is that these things, though, I wanted to talk about it. So they have these new Mondo, what are these called? Mondo Tiki mugs of Godzilla and Kong, though. So I heard of these and I've seen these before. These mug things, so these tiki mugs, though, they, and most of them were pretty cool, though. Like, I like the horror ones they did, like, the Creeper, Leprechaun, Jason, Pennywise, all that, but they never had one that I was, like, super interested in grabbing, though, and now that they have, Godzilla and Kong ones, I might be going my way to get these, though, most definitely, though. So they look pretty cool. I would like both of them together, though. So, let's see what else, though. So I'm reading off of a few sites that are here that I think are worth mentioning. All right. So also what's next is that they revealed, if you guys haven't seen already, they revealed the new Godzilla and Kong figures from SH Monster Arts, though. Well, on their website, they have these two along with another mystery monster, which everyone's saying might be Mechagodzilla, but we're not sure. And another one is the another Monster Hunter monster. But to be honest, the Godzilla, I'm looking at pictures of it right now. The Godzilla, it's the same as a little bit similar to the 2019 Godzilla, though. But he has like the full glowing fins, though, and like a glowing mouth. And I just love those hands, man. Those hand accessories. They're like the sprawled out open hands, like he's on the attack. Look really cool, though. And for right now, I still do believe they are up on pre-order for right now. If you look on sites like Hobby Link Japan, Big Bad Toy Store, they are still up for grabs, though, and pre-order. I'm gonna eventually pre-order these guys soon, though, because I haven't gotten a Monster Arts in like the longest time, though. And I like the 2019 figure that came out. I don't have it, though, but this would be a nice supplement of that, though, this new 2021, I guess, Godzilla, you could call him, though, but I don't know. But the Kong looks really cool, though. He's got his axe, though, and he has, like, a normal head and, like, a roaring head. Though, in these battle poses, you can even get him, like, on all fours and stuff. Though, like, it looks really neat, though, this new type of figure. Like, this Kong looks really cool, though, this figure, I think, though. So, that was the Monster Arts figures there. So, what else is here? Though, you mean, okay. All right, I burped, and that's nice. I don't know what that was. All right, let's not do that then, I guess. Though, let's not have stuff in the background like that. Let's not do that. That's a no-no then, I guess. What was I saying? Oh, anyway. So there, if you guys haven't already, I already bought mine, so it's perfectly cool. You'll be seeing them soon. The official Godzilla vs. Kong merch from Amazon. Though, that they have here, they have, like, Team Godzilla shirt, Team, Kong, though, they have, like, a bunch of stuff, they have, like, hoodies, though, and, pillows, and, like, whatchamacallit, like, bags and phone cases, though, I believe, I think they even have, like, some other stuff, I'm not sure, though, I believe they made some new stuff for Valentine's Day, but I'm not getting up to that yet, though, but yeah, they made these cool shirts. I bought mine already, which is Team Godzilla. And I bought another one for somebody else, though, so I can't wait for that to come out. But due to the weather, if you guys haven't heard, at the time of this recording, the weather's not been doing great. It's global warming happening around here, though, so it's pretty crazy. Everyone's orders is not coming in, and everything might be delayed, so it's like, it's not good, though. But anyway, that was that, the official Amazon, official Godzilla vs. Kong news that's out, at least. What else is here? Okay, that's not until later. If you guys haven't seen it, the Funko Pop Godzilla vs. Kong figures, if you haven't seen those yet. Though there is, I already pre-ordered a few of these, or I bought a few of these already. They haven't showed up yet. But you have like a Godzilla Kong with orange eyes, though. People are speculating on why Kong has orange eyes. Though, it is kind of weird, though. Actually, there's a Godzilla with atomic breath. It looks cool. There's, like, a Kong with, scratches on his chest, though. Like, they're fresh, and he's holding, like, a crane. This Kong with the battle axe. Then there's, like, these cute little keychain, Godzilla and Kong. And then there's the two giant, jumbo-sized pops. The 10-inch, figures they made, though, of Godzilla and King Kong. I bought my first, 10-inch Funko Pop. It is the Child's Play 2 Chucky, though, so I bought a giant figure to see what, just to be in store for, like, okay, how big are these things gonna be, and it's pretty big. I can't imagine how big these two would be. There is also the FY exclusive of the Atomic Breath Godzilla, where it's, like, glow-in-the-dark, and then there's the BAM exclusive, where it's the two-pack of Godzilla and Kong, so if you didn't want to get them separately, you could get them in a two-pack. And as well as that, there's a Walmart exclusive of the 10-inch jumbo figures where Godzilla's like this really nice blue. And for some reason, Kong is in this purple. Though, I guess it makes sense. I don't know. I don't know why. Anyway. Yeah, I don't know why, though. My dog just showed up. That's why I paused there. Or whatever, though, what's going on. And I'm trying to hit this and it's not working for me. So anyway, what the hell are we talking about? Sorry, I had to cut that off real quick, though, so... okay, we were talking about the Godzilla Funkos, am I right? Yeah, we were. Not to that yet. Oh, there is this thing that's happening. Since NECA, lost the rights to Godzilla, we know they're not making any Godzilla stuff anymore. There was a post on, I believe, the official Godzilla page? Yeah, there was. On Instagram... It is a collaboration between a company called Super 7 that it says here, it's like excited about our collaboration with Super 7. This is a Godzilla reaction figure and capsule collection, including apparel and accessories coming this year. Ultimates figures coming 2022. So I think it's like they're making like t-shirts and stuff. Though whatever though, like yeah, they're making t-shirts. I believe, well, I could read right here, though, so, I'm not sure, so it's the debut, 3.75 articulated Godzilla reaction figure is scheduled to arrive this summer, along with a capsule collection offering various products, including apparel and, wait, did I read the accessories? More Godzilla product will follow later in the year, so yeah, they're making, like, a 3.75 articulated figures, so one figure, I think, and, like, a bunch of stuff, so, like, capsules, like, you know those kind of things you get at, like, at a dollar store, you put a quarter in, and it's, like, the little toys in there, I guess, and they're making t-shirts and whatnot. I think that's what it is, though, but it's pretty cool. I never heard of Super 7, so I'm pretty excited for that, though, so that was another piece of news. I thought that was interesting. What else is here, though? Oh, if you guys remember, I made the video, but I never posted it. The Rumble movie, the animated giant monster movie where it's a bunch of giant monsters like wrestling in the ring and stuff. Apparently, it is delayed to 2022, though. I think it was supposed to come out this year, I think, though. I believe it was supposed to come out this year in May, I think, but I guess due to everything that's going on, they had to push it back, yeah, into February 18th of 2022, so, it was, like, an animated movie with, Will Arnett as a giant monster, though, and it was, like, wrestling stuff, kind of like that, though, so they were gonna wrestle, with each other and stuff, so, I thought that was just a little thing to, whatchamacallit talk about there, though, so, what else is here, though, what else? I have all this stuff opened up, though, but I have it seemingly apparently out of order, though. I don't know why, but it's a little weird, though, so, okay. Yeah, I talked about that. So I guess I'll show these off, though, or whatever. There's this Godzilla comic book that was announced, though IDW got the rights back to Godzilla. And they're making this, like, sort of kid, I think it's marketed to younger children. It's called Godzilla Monster Protectors, though, and it's gonna be a 4-issue comic series about a group of kids and the twin fairies from Mothra trying to help like Godzilla understand like the world around him, though, because like there's these greedy businessmen making energy efficient stuff for the Earth, and Godzilla does not like that, though, so he just proceeds to destroy it, and they're like, no, Godzilla, don't do that. The artwork looks pretty cool, though, from what they've shown. It looks pretty neato, though. I like it, though, so that's a little bit thing. It's cool that IDW got the rights back to Godzilla, though, which is pretty interesting. What else is here? So, let's see. Oh, there's these, I think people are saying that these were unmade, figures, but then there's sources that say they were, are gonna be made, I think. There's these mini Playmates Godzilla versus Kong figures that showed up before in pictures. Of there's Godzilla Kong, one of the Warbats, Skullcrawler, Behemoth, and one of these new creatures, though, I think it's those bat creatures. It's called a Hellhawk, I think. Though I'm not. I think that's what it was. Though yeah. I think that's what it was. Something like that. Though, but, the sources I found that either say they were, like, not released, or that they are gonna be released, though. It's weird, I don't know. But I thought it'd be cool to, talk about those right there. They look pretty cool. It's cool that there's these little minifigures of the monster zone. Behemoth's got his own figure, so that's quite interesting right there. The back of the box is cool with the artwork on the back with Godzilla and Kong looking at each other there, so that's cool. All right, what else is here? I guess I should talk about that Shin Ultraman trailer along with the stuff that was shown for that movie. Though, so they have the two figures of the monsters, Naranga, that other creature. I don't know what its name is, though. It's got like the open flower face almost. It's got like drills in the back of it, though. And the Ultraman himself as a figure, and even making the Ultraman as a SH Figure Arts or S Ultra Ak, I believe. Though, and to talk about those, I want to pre. I'm trying to pre-order the two monsters, and I want to pre-order the SH figure of the Shin Ultraman because the band, it just stands there. It's cool, but it's like, it just kind of stands there, doesn't do much. With my humanoid superhero figures like that, I would want them with articulation so I could pose them with the Bandai monsters, though. So, whatchamacallit. But the trailer for the movie looks cool. It looks very similar. It's the same people who worked on Shin Godzilla, Hideki Hayano and Shinji Higuchi, I believe, because that's what the announcement said a while back when they announced the film. Though, but the trailer looks cool. Like, it's a mixture of Shin Godzilla, with the political stuff happening and people in suits, though, and it looks like a little bit more action-packed and sillier. But the CG, I think, works fine with Ultraman. Like, the monsters look cool, though, at least, though. But was I, and am I the only one who's, like, disappointed in the, whatchamacallit, the design of, I almost said Godzilla, the design of Ultraman? Because, like, I know it's Shin, though, it's called Shin, but it's not, like, the same thing, though, it's not gonna be that. But knowing, Anno, like, him working on the Evangelion series, or Evangelion, whatever the hell you wanna call it, though, and, like, all his other stuff, like, you would think, like, they would do something new with Ultraman. Like, to me, the Ultraman design just looks like the original Ultraman, but with a color swap. Like, maybe the red is in a different spot. It just looks like the same thing again. Like, and I know they need to keep the look of an Ultraman consistent for marketing and stuff, but at least they could have made it, like, interesting, like an alien or something weird that we haven't seen, though. Like, the monsters look cool. They look really well designed. The Ultraman is just kind of to me. Like, I'm not really thrilled. I'm very disappointed on the Ultraman design. Like, they could have made something look so much cooler fighting against these other monsters, but they didn't do it, though. So I think I'm pretty excited for the movie. I'll see if it comes out, or hopefully when it comes out, though, if they have more monsters or something, though, or whatever they're gonna do with it. But it looks pretty neato. I think it's cool. It's just the Ultraman design for me is just disappointing, though. So let's see what else is here. Oh, for those of you who want cool ass bed sets, they have a Godzilla vs. Kong, I think it's a quilt and pillow sheet, set, though, for all you who want that. And as well, they are making a Bandai Movie Monster series, King Kong figure for the new movie, Godzilla vs. Kong, as well as I think one image I saw or report said they're making the Godzilla as well, though, with each other, though, or something like that, though. So, I'm definitely getting those. I missed out on the King of the Monsters figures, though. I don't have any of them, unfortunately, yet, though. But it looks pretty cool, though. Of course, everyone knows I love my Bandai, so I'll definitely grab those guys when it comes out, especially that Kong, though. It's cool that Japan's making Kong figures, though, now. But now, one of the big other news I really wanted to talk about was the announcement of finally a Cloverfield 2 is happening. A sequel to Cloverfield is happening, and that scared the shit out of me. I just heard something in the background, if none of you. Alright, back to what I was saying. And yeah, that there's the announcement that they're doing a Cloverfield 2 sequel. And apparently it isn't gonna be found footage from what I heard, though, which is sort of disappointing, though. But isn't that exciting? Finally, it's not this anthology, whatever bullshit universe they were trying to build with this, though. But for years since, like, the first movie, I always told, like, my friends and stuff, especially my best friend Elijah, though, if you guys see him on Instagram or something. I always wanted a part two. Like, who wouldn't, since they've been talking about it, though? Like, I wanted to know more. I wanted to see more of what was happening. Like, is the monster alive? Is it dead? It's apparently a direct sequel, though, to the first movie, though. If it's gonna explore if the monster's dead or what's happening, though, like, or any more story to tell with it, though. I'm just excited that they're finally doing it. They finally came to their senses and they're like, you know what? Let's stop this confused sort of anthology connected, not so really confused, fucked up universe we were trying to build, though, this bullshit. So finally we're getting what we wanted with this, though. What I wanted, at least, though. So, all right, so I already talked about that, though. I talked about that. What's this? Okay, yeah, I think I already talked about that. Yeah, I talked about this. Oh, there is, for you guys and everyone who's been saying, including myself, I called it that, a lot of people too, but they were, a lot of people, including myself, were saying, like, with the new NECA Kong figure, they could totally make like a 33, like just repaint it like black and white or something. But no, they subverted our expectations and they made this, I think they said a poster version. Or what I call the tribal paint, because it looks like tribal paint to me. This weird repaint of King Kong that they're doing, though, NECA, though. Apparently, it's inspired by the most random thing you could think of. It was a Famous Monsters of Filmland front cover. Apparently, it was inspired by with the colors, though. It's really random and weird. It looks cool, though. I like the colors on it, but it's like it's kind of random and weird to me. Though, like, it's cool looking again, though. It'll be nice to get another Kong, but it's cool to get a crazy colored Kong. But it's like, is it, how random? You could have done like anything. You just chose a front cover of Famous Monsters of Filmland as your inspiration. Okay. what else is here to talk about here, though? So, yeah, so I think it's pretty cool, but it's kind of random in my opinion. It's like, oh, like, how weird. Is that right? You know what I mean? What else is here? So, oh, FYE, announced this the new their Godzilla's Kong merchandise. They're making king size candy bars, though, which look pretty cool. Actually, I never saw what the flavors are. So this one is fiery chili chocolate dark chocolate, and one's banana crunch milk chocolate. Oh, that sounds pretty good, though. So these are like FYE exclusive since they make a lot of that shit. Though, they're making apparently, I think, an energy drink. I think it is. I'm not sure. Ultimate Showdown energy with every sip blueberry raspberry flavored drink. So, it looks pretty cool. You know, I'm getting this shit. And everyone knows that this is already gonna be an internet challenge on the internet. So, Heat Ray, every meal. It's apparently a Godzilla Heat Ray hot sauce. So, it's pretty cool, though. You know, I'm probably gonna have to try this. Though I would be definitely, since I love FYE, good friends of mine, though. I wish I was sponsored by them, though, but I shop there all the time, though, so you know I'm definitely gonna grab that shit when it comes out. But am I also the only one who's a little bit nitpicky when it comes to now? Like, apparently every marketing this year now just calls Godzilla's atomic breath Heat Ray, though. Like, it's atomic breath. Like, I understand that calling it atomic like has to do with nuclear weapons and shit, and like talking about nuclear stuff is like sort of like a no-no or like a taboo. But can you at least just call it by its name? It's called atomic breath, not heat ray. He's not shooting fire. He's shooting nuclear energy out of his fucking mouth. Like, I'm not super into that though. Though it's just kind of weird to me. It's like saying ice breath, but whatever. There was an announcement as well of these new Sufubi puppet mascot finger puppets, though. They're really super cute. Though there's, I guess they're gonna be like these blind bags. You could buy these now. I don't remember where I saw you could get these, though. But they have like 54 Godzilla, Burning Godzilla, Shin, of course, he's gonna be there. Rodan, Mothra Larva, Ghidorah, Hedorah, Mechagodzilla 74, Biollante, and one of the juvenile destroyers in the set. I think they look super cute, though. I don't know how. Well, Shin Godzilla could be cute even if he's really disgustingly ugly, though, or just gnarly looking though, but they look pretty cute. I have a few of these types of finger puppet Godzilla things in my collection actually though, anyways, so it seems pretty cool though. So let's see what else here. So just to keep on track of what I'm talking about. Yep. So if you guys haven't seen in other countries, these are already coming out. If you aren't on Instagram or any Twitter, Facebook or anything, there's these new mega like sounds giant Godzilla and Kong figures that are coming out. There's one where Godzilla lights up and he like shoots like a little atomic breath, a little beam out of his mouth though, and it roars. It looks pretty cool. And it has like a little soldier guy that goes in scale with the Godzilla, as well as there's this weird jack jaw Kong though that has like a swinging action. He roars with his axe though, which looks pretty cool. You know, I'm grabbing these though, but I need to make more room for these giant figures I always get though. But to me, the jaw, it has like a weird seam line and it looks a little weird. Like his jaw like is supposed to open like kind of a weird way to me though. Like he's got like a weird like jaw though, but it doesn't bother me too much though. And he also will come with a little soldier guy to go and scale with him though, whatever though. Godzilla's mouth moves, which is pretty cool. I didn't notice that before though. So does Kong's mouth move? No, it does not. They both have lights and sound, if I did not mention that already though. So what else do I want to talk about though? So we know that the if you haven't seen my videos of it already, the Pacific Rim Black anime show is coming out March 4th. March 4th on Netflix, though, the 3D anime that takes place, I think, from what I've been told, it's, I think, in the middle of the war, because in the show they talk about, apparently the whole continent of Australia is taken over by kaiju, so now it's up to these two characters to find their parents and take back the land that they lived on, or live on. So I think that's what pretty much is happening there though. But if you haven't seen my thoughts or want to know my thoughts on the show and what it looks like in itself though, you should watch my trailer reaction that I did to it a while back though. I think it was one of the newest videos I uploaded though. It's still getting like shit ton of views right now as we speak though, so it's pretty crazy though. But thanks for the support, you guys though. But my short little rundown, it looks really cool. I can't wait for it. It looks sick. I love the animation style in this. It looks way better than the Godzilla anime trilogy that came out though, but I'm pretty excited. Everyone knows I'm a big Pacific Rim fan, so it looks pretty cool. What else is there to see? Oh, there's a new NECA Kong apparently creature accessory pack that's like a pterodactyl and like some type of it almost looks like the two-legged lizard from the 33 movie though. But of course these are like stylized, not supposed to be the creatures from the movie because copyright issues, I guess though. But they look pretty cool. I would get these to pose with my Kong and stuff, and my stuff there. I have a pretty much growing collection of Kong stuff now, thanks to this new movie though, so I'm pretty excited for that though. But other thing there, oh, I can't hit anything, okay, whatever. There's also these other Godzilla vs. Kong figures. They're called Battle Roar. They're the same thing as the big ones that I mentioned though a few minutes ago, but except they're smaller and there's like a button to press on it, and it just they just both make sounds. They don't light up or shoot anything. They just make sounds. There's a Godzilla and there's like a grinning Kong or whatever though. Godzilla's like standing straight up on his back though, like he's really having a stretch day almost though. The Kong and Godzilla do look cool though. I seen pictures of what they look like though. They do look a little weird, especially Godzilla standing like completely straight with his back, on his head pointing towards the sky though, but it still looks pretty cool though. And earlier today, just as a little side thing, I went to Walmart today and almost all of the Godzilla vs. Kong stuff is like cleared out, so that kind of shows you the hype for the movie is pretty real though with what's going on now though, so since people are probably going to go see it though. So if I exclude anything, it's because either I didn't find it worth mentioning on my channel or in this video though, or I just didn't have time to run all of it into this podcast episode. There is children's books, if you guys did not hear, There is some kids' books coming out for Godzilla vs. Kong. The first one they revealed is a cute little one called Kong and Me. It's with the character Gia, who's with Kong in this movie, though. So it looks pretty nice. I'll probably pick the kids' books up because why not? Though, like of course, why not? And by the way, they're on Amazon now. There is a pre-order for the independent monster movie that ships in July. Howl from the Beyond the Fog. It's up for pre-order on Amazon right now. It's like $13.99 from the image I'm looking at, though. So if you wanted to get it like I am, you could pick it up there though, because I missed out on all the cool stuff that showed up for this movie though, since I was pretty excited when it was coming out though, and I was like, I'm gonna watch that. But that's a way to watch it. You mean that's not good. I need a drink. All right, I'm good. All right, so this is one of the exciting news. I bet you everyone had the big Godzilla like the Godzilla fever when this showed up. So Playmates announced that they are doing not only a burning Godzilla figure, which looks sick as hell, though, and as I already have like two burning Godzilla figures though, but I really think this one looks really nice. But also they're doing a Jet Jaga, da 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 da. This could replace my custom that I made, though. You know I'm picking this up because I don't have Jet Jaguar in my collection though. I never got the Bandai or any of the other figures they made of him. I definitely cannot afford the Bandai premium fucking figure with the tiny one, the interchangeable hands, and like the growing effect that comes with them. So this is my next best bet though, and he's in a really cool pose, like where he's in a fighting pose. Though, so you know I'm picking my favorite robot, Jaguar boy up though, so he looks really cool. Then Playmates has definitely stepped up the game. Not me personally saying that they were bad, they were just kind of hits and miss. Like I think some of them are fine though, they're not super awful though. But then some of them are like, yeah, they could have at least tried a little better. I'm not saying like a lot of people like, oh, they were awful cheap ass figures though. They took molds from NECA. Like I'm just saying, oh, they could have been better. Though at least what they had though, so they're stepping up their game now, what the figures they're doing now at least, though, especially with the new movie coming out. So for Valentine's Day, since it by the time it was recording it already passed, whatchamacallit, there was these Godzilla Valentine's Day cards were pretty cool though looking though. They had like a few, I believe, if I could find where they were at though. There was like one with Space Godzilla, Biollante, Godzilla, Ghidorah, and Mechagodzilla. And then of course they had like these corny things, like sayings on them or whatever those. So it was something. It was pretty cool. I think I might have this. Yeah, I do. They showed the cover to the Godzilla versus Kong art book though, which is like a mural painting. It looks pretty cool. It's like all in red though, but it looks pretty cool. No, I don't have any of these art books, these concept art books though, because I never usually grab them though. I really want to, but I just don't have the money to grab those though, unfortunately, though, or whatever though. So I thought that was worth mentioning at least. What else do we have here that I did not talk about yet? Oh, there is another children's book for Godzilla vs. Kong. It's called Sometimes Friends Fight. It's like a little cute kitty book to teach shit kids, I guess, on how to be a good friend though, and also counting though, because in the pages like they have like a little saying like on how to be a good friend, and also like count how many things are on the page though. So it's pretty cute though. It's cool that it's funny to think like this movie about these two fucking monsters fighting each other to the death, that there's these kids books about them being cutesy friends. I like to always imagine that anyways though, that Godzilla and Kong are actually friends behind the screen, behind the camera, like they just go out and get a beer, like, oh hey, oh, we're done filming though. What do you want to do? Godzilla's like, I don't know. You want to go play some poker? It's like, yeah, sure. Next thing on the list, actually one of the few last things to talk about though, at least. So, if you guys remember those keychain, Godzilla things they had series one and series two. I only grabbed a few from series one, though. I have two Godzillas. One of the Godzillas hangs on my keys though for my car. They're doing series three, now, which has a few good monsters, a pretty good selection, mostly from the Millennium series, as well as some from the Showa era. Though, at least I believe, yeah, some Showa era stuff, because they have Godzilla 2000, Anguirus, Monster X, though, which is crazy to see Monster X coming back for something in a while. Ibra, Orga, Megaguirus, Hedra, Gigan, King Caesar, and the two exclusives, like, mystery ones, which I believe are Manda, wrapped around the Atragon or Gotengo, and Shin Godzilla with the beady eyes, though. He looks super cute, though, but whatever. Though, so those are Series 3, and as well as they're doing some for Godzilla vs. Kong, though, which look pretty cool. So they have Godzilla Kong, the Skullcrawler, Warbat, and Atomic Breath Godzilla Kong, his axe, the Hellhawk, Jaya's doll. I don't know why they have a Godzilla vs. Kong logo one. And of course, I don't know what Exclusive B is, but we all know what the fuck Exclusive A is. It's Mechagodzilla. And as well as Funko has Mechagodzilla listed on the back of the box, so they have a Mechagodzilla figure in the works. So can we again say that, is it really a spoiler at this point? Because thanks to Playmates with the leaks, is it considered spoiler anymore, since everyone knows Mechagodzilla is going to be in the movie anyways? So that's just me, but whatever. Yeah, so I talked about the clip things there, so we're reaching, unfortunately, the end. I thought this would be longer. I think it is longer, so I got a few other things here, though, so I'll let you guys look at the screen and see some other things I probably forgot, though, to talk about. At least, though, like I said earlier, there was these Valentine's Day Kids Godzilla vs. Kong t-shirts, though. I like the Team Godzilla one. It's super cute, though, and the Valentine's Day ones are really cute, especially the one with the why can't we be friends? Why can't we be friends? Why can't we? That one is really cute, especially the other one where Godzilla's shooting, like, atomic breath hearts at Kong, though, which is pretty funny. Though, it reminds me of something I did, though, for this Valentine's Day, though. Go to tpublic.com to pick up yours now. But they look pretty cute, though. I don't think they are adult size, because they're marketing these ones towards kids, so it's pretty fine. You got a little cutesy-wootsy, chibi Godzilla and Kong just fighting each other, I guess. They also did it for the Chinese New Year. They had, like, these little cute Godzilla and Kong chibi characters just, like, these little cartoons, like, doing stuff, though, for the Lunar New Year, I believe. Yeah, they did. Though, so I think the last few things to talk about are, these other figures that I wasn't excited to get, wasn't thinking of planning, and now I am. I'm like, yeah, might as well grab them, I guess. Though, if you guys haven't heard, you guys know Chibi Godzilla, right? You guys know what that is. It's a cute little broccoli Godzilla for kids. It's like 2D animated. It came out a while back for kids, though, whatever, though. So they also have this show for kids. It's sort of like Sesame Street Bubba Godzilla, and it's called Godziban. And just for this video, for you guys, and I was gonna make this video, I I tortured myself in watching this this show with no subtitles, no dub, and I love the shit out of it. It's the weirdest. Godzilla's done a lot of weird things, and I've seen Godzilla do a lot of weird stuff, though, in his 60-year career, and this is another one to add on to that list of crazy shit. Though, it's like a talking puppet Godzilla with his two sons, little Godzilla and Minya, though, and there's all the other monsters talking and doing, like, goofy, silly shit and adventure stuff, though. It's pretty funny. Though they're all puppet green screen kind of thing, though. It's super cute since they're, like, adorable little monsters, though, almost, though. But they're making figures of the Godzilla family, I could call it, though. They're making Godzilla or Godziban, Minya, and Little Godzilla as Bandai Movie Monster figures. I guess for the kids in Japan who watch that, though. And it's also on YouTube if you guys ever want to watch the episodes. Though, I would definitely recommend watching them. If you want some weird, crazy Godzilla shit, or if your girlfriend's into Godzilla and she think, and if you want to show her something cutesy-wootsy that's Godzilla, I think you'll get enjoyment out of this. I do recommend not watching it with subtitles or dub. It's way more better to just guess everything, though, because that's what I did, though, actually. But that was one of the last pieces of news, though. I guess I'll save the best thing for last. I was probably going to make a full video on this, but I guess I'll just throw it into here. They revealed, finally, the design of Singular Point Godzilla, the new anime that's come out in April on Netflix as well as Japan. They revealed the design of Godzilla. And if you guys have not seen my Instagram post of Prince Moon 54, I fucking called it. I thought for the longest time, though, with this design before they revealed it, I posted on my Instagram that I did a sketch drawing of what Godzilla was going to look like. And I was thinking, like, since they're not limited to a man in a suit or, like, practical effects, they have CG just, like, computers and stuff to work with this Godzilla design. I thought this Godzilla would be, like, a dinosaur. Like, he would have, like, the theropod-type legs, the spikes on his arms and stuff, though, and, like, the crocodilian-type tail and spikes going all down his body and stuff. And my design is amazingly... My prediction was amazingly correct and close, because this Godzilla design, though, looks fucking sick. I like this Godzilla, though I didn't think he was going to be black. I, for some reason, thought he was going to be either, like, purple or red or something, but I love this new Godzilla design. It's already grown on me. I said it, if you guys haven't seen my trailer reaction videos for the Singular Point anime of Godzilla, this Godzilla looks fucking mean. Like, this is a pissed, angry, like, edgy, spiky Godzilla, though, with the crazy teeth, though, the Shin Godzilla like design, though. He's got, like, spikes all over his neck here, though, and these big dinosaurian legs, though. I don't think he looks thick, personally. Not like the Heisei Godzilla design. Like, that was a chunky boy, though, honestly, though. The really long, like, tail, though, and the arms, and I love that they had the arm spikes, because I called it. I, like, for some reason, I was like, you know what, this Godzilla might have arm spikes. And what do you know? They have this arm spikes on this Godzilla. And the fins look really cool, though, especially, like, with this new thing. Like, they have, like, these, like, red veins in it. I wonder if they glow, like, when he shoots his atomic breath. But that's why I'm really curious. It's cool that we finally get to see what this Godzilla design looks like. I'm pretty excited to see this thing move, actually, now, though. Like, now that I got a feel for this design, I want to see it move and, like, run and, like, do stuff, though. And the fins, it's like the Godzilla design, it's like a mixture of Millennium, Shin, sort of Heisei, dinosaurian theropod dinosaur design, with the fins sort of Shin 54 mixed in there, though, with a little bit of Millennium as well. Though I just love this Godzilla design, like, right off the bat, like, when I saw, well, when that first image of the Godzilla came out, I was like, oh, it looks pretty cool. It looks like stuff we've seen before, but it looks pretty cool. And then once they showed, like, more, like, in the trailer and the posters and stuff, and we got more images, I was like, yeah, this Godzilla, especially when that trailer came on, we saw only his eyes and his face. I was like, yeah, like, okay, this Godzilla design is growing on me. He's automatically cool. And now that they showed this image, I'm like, all right, I love this Godzilla design now. Though I can't wait to see it move and, like, do stuff and fight other monsters and jump around, maybe. Though, whatever this Godzilla could do, though, would be interesting. And I can't wait to see what this offers, though, in the future, though. So, that's it for the news stuff. That's all the news so far with the, So, that's all the news so far, though, at least in this video. Again, if I missed anything, it's probably because I forgot or I didn't think it was worth mentioning, or that this video is not in that point, though. So if, like, oh, you forgot about this new piece of news, well, you can't blame me, because I can't predict the future with this kind of stuff, though. So hope you guys enjoyed this episode, though, or this podcast of all the stuff here, and thought my opinions of it and stuff like that, though. Eventually all this stuff will be going on Instagram, and I'll be posting my thoughts on Instagram for you people who want to know my thoughts and stuff on a lot of things, though, over there, though, if you don't have Anchor and all that, though. And same thing with YouTube. This episode will be going up on my YouTube channel as well, though, so you can find all my links, though, of course, somewhere. I have a YouTube, Facebook, TikTok, Instagram, though. I have a TeePublic account, as I said, though, so you can buy designs and t-shirts with my artwork on it, though. And I'll be doing more in the future as well soon, though. I might be taking a break, though, because I have other videos on my YouTube channel I need to work on, as well as a lot of other stuff I've been putting on hold, though, that I need to put my time and effort into doing those. So, yep, so hope you guys enjoyed this this podcast, this regular back to formula episode, though. So, yep, so hope you guys enjoyed listening to me. Check out all my stuff, as I said. Ignore all the noise you guys hear. I really apologize with the fucking noise that you hear all the time with this. I'm sorry you guys had to deal with it. The worst is I had to deal with it, okay? So, yep, so hope you guys enjoyed. I'll see you guys all next time. I'm Audi 5000, and remember to respect the Monstars. And I'll see you guys all in the next one, though. And I'm Audi 5000. I'm out. So, thank you for listening.